Hello everyone, my name is Franco Terrazzano. I am the Alberta Director for the Canadian Taxpayers Federation, and we had a busy week full of news that Alberta taxpayers need to know about. And of course, we have to start in Ottawa with a Supreme Court ruling that found Trudeau's carbon tax to be legal in a split decision. Now, of course, the Canadian Taxpayers Federation is disappointed about this. We were the only non-government official intervener fighting against Trudeau's carbon tax. But we have to point out, just because it's legal, it doesn't mean the federal government or a federal government needs to impose a carbon tax. So just because Trudeau can hammer families and businesses with a crippling carbon tax, it doesn't mean he has to, and it doesn't mean he should. Now, one of the big issues that we're worried about, especially in Alberta, is that this carbon tax case and ruling could further open the door to allow the federal government to continue to step on the province of Alberta's and other provinces' toes. And don't worry though, the CTF, we're going to continue to fight this carbon tax, and we're going to really ramp up our efforts in the court of public opinion. Now let's switch gears a little bit and go to the province of Alberta that just passed its 2021 budget this week. But unfortunately, not a lot of good news in this 2021 budget with bigger spending, bigger deficits, and bigger debt. Now let this point sink in, but the Alberta government under Premier Jason Kenney is going to be outspending the New Democrats. You heard that right. The provincial government, the United Conservatives under Premier Kenney, is going to be spending more money than the NDP did back in 2018, even after accounting for inflation and population growth. So not a lot of good news in the Alberta budget, and also not a lot of good news in the municipal realm either at the city of Calgary, where we're just hearing that nearly 14,000 city hall bureaucrats received a pay raise last year during lockdowns and restrictions. So talk about a slap in the face for so many Calgarians who took huge pay cut or who may have lost their job, lost their livelihoods, or lost their business to know that part of their tax bill went to pay for pay raises for city hall bureaucrats in 2020. Nearly 14,000 of them got a pay raise, and pay raises at the city of Calgary going back to 2015 cost about $230 million. Wow. Okay, let's take a little preview for the week ahead. It is April Fool's Day, and unfortunately, it looks like the joke is going to be on taxpayers. Come April 1, we're going to be seeing the federal carbon tax go up, federal booze taxes go up, and it turns out our members of parliament are set to receive another pay raise. Yeah, so much for being in this all together. Well, if you want to learn more, head over to our newsroom at taxpayer.com and stay tuned.